Very good morning. Welcome to Financial Freedom Show. I'm C.S. Sudhir. Miss Lakshmi has posted a question on the Financial Freedom app. She says, I'm an artisan and I'm into handicrafts. I wish to export my products to different countries. How do I do that? In fact, handicraft business globally, the handicraft market is worth about $1 trillion globally, which means it is worth about 75 lakh crore in Indian rupees. But do you know what is the total value of handicraft being exported from India? It is just about 15,000 crore. It is some 0.3, 0.1, 0.2%. Just think about it. In a 75 lakh crore worth global handicrafts market, India is exporting just about 0.2%. India's population is almost 20% of global population. Then our handicrafts export should have been at least 20% of global value, market value. Why is this not happening? I feel, you know, here we have to blame the government for not doing what they should have done. In fact, off late, I see a lot of measures being taken by the government to encourage artisans to export handicrafts to different countries. But even then, I just don't see enough traction. Handicrafts export is a very profitable business. Number one, in India, we have got cheap labor, right? The labor cost is very cheap. And handicrafts is all about, you know, handmade stuff. It is all about, you know, without any machines and all that, right? So because of that, India can actually play the bigger hand. There are primarily two types of handicrafts. Number one, consumer goods for daily use. And number two, decorative items. So these are the two large categories. So now if you wish to export handicrafts from India to the different parts of the world, number one, you have to have a registered firm. It can be a sole proprietorship, partnership, or a private limited company, or a one-person company, doesn't matter, but you need to have a registered firm. And you should have export, import-export certificate. That is also, that's very important. And number three, you should have registration with Export Promotion Council for Handicrafts. That's again very important, because once you register your products, your firm with them, they will also promote your products across the globe. They should actually do that ideally, but it's not happening in the right way. That's something which is missing. Otherwise, our artisans would have actually done a lot better. Today, most of the artisans, their products are being sold locally, within their district, within their town, within their city. They are not able to take it beyond because Export Promotion Council for Handicrafts is not doing a great job. And the GST registration, which is very important. And then MSME registration, if you have it, you can actually enjoy some of these benefits. Then if you have trademark or anything of that sort, I mean, if it's an option, you know, trademark, it's not compulsory. If you have these stuffs, you will be able to export. See, now when we talk about handicraft business, number one, learning the art of doing it, because it's an art, right? Handicraft is all about an art. It's not something to be done by using machines, or it's not a technology driven thing. It is more of a handmade stuff. So one, you have to learn the art. Number two, you should learn how to market it, right? To different parts of the world. How do you market it? So that you have to learn. And number three, you should learn the business, which means the finance, accounts, and various other things, the trademark, IPs, and all that, right? That's the third part of it. So download Financial Freedom app from Play Store or App Store and learn how to build successful handicraft business in India, which can export its products to different parts of the world, on Financial Freedom app now. Not just that, on Financial Freedom app, we have over 50 livelihood and financial education courses. Watch all these courses. These courses will help you build your life. Also, if you have any questions related to personal finance, business, career, or farming, post your questions on the Financial Freedom app. We will come back to you with an answer in my next episode. Thanks for watching. Be wise, get rich.